to my channel. Okay, so for today's video is we're going to have a Q&A, a question and answer portion. Yay! So for today's video is I randomly selected different questions from different people. I randomly asked them to give me a question about anything, about my life, my studies, or about anything. So yes, let's start. Okay, so for the question number one, shake it. Okay, let's have here. Yay! A question number one is from Tristan J. Balog. So his question is, "Nganong buutan ka?" Really? Okay, so based on this question, "Nganong buutan daw ko?" Ibig sabihin is, bakit daw ako mabait? Bakit ka ba ako mabait? So, I can consider na, as always, na mabait. Siguro ano lang kasi, dapat lang kasi na maging mabait tayo sa kapwa-tao natin. Kasi, pag maging mabait tayo sa kapwa-tao natin, is yung kabutihan na pinakita at ibinigay natin sa kanila, is siya namang babalik sa atin. At isa pa, napakagaan naman talaga sa loob na maging mabait ka sa ibang tao. So, anong butan ka? So, yeah, that's it. Yeah. Okay, let's proceed to the next question. Question number two. Here we go. Okay, question number two. From this is... Oh. Actually, napakarami ng question niya. It's from Ate Rodaine Idusma. So, her question, as you can see, umabot talaga sa likod. So, napakaraming question ni Ate Rodaine. So, okay. So, first question ni Ate Rodaine, second question na pala, is, unsa inspirasyon ni mo para mag-start a vlog? Of course, my inspiration is my family. Next question is, who's my favorite vlogger nimo and why? Okay, my favorite vlogger is Miss Francine Diaz. Why? Since aside from her na actress siya, is kwan simple. She's a kind of girl na simple. Then wala siya kayo mga arte. Hindi siya masyadong maarte. Simple. Then of course mabait. And of course, most important of all is my kanang ano siya, God-fearing. She's a kind of girl na God-fearing. So, she's my favorite vlogger. Next question is, if ever na mo famous ka through vlogging, unsay gusto buhaton nimo? So, if ever I became famous through vlogging, I would like to do continue what I'm doing. Since through vlogging, then if I became a famous, then I want to continue vlogging to continue spreading my knowledge, my experiences, and of course to give fun, inspiration, and to help other people as well. Okay, next question is, unsaon nimo pagtabang sa ubang tao? Okay, so ano lang siya? Unsaon yung pagtabang sa ubang tao if ma-famous na ko through vlogging? So yeah, continue na sa yung pagsali ko ng mga inspirational na mga messages. So unsaon yung pagtabang sa ubang tao? Continue to inspire them and give them lessons na it's better to fight for your dreams together with God. Yung yung lahat ng ginagawa mo, dapat salihan mo ng pagtitiwala kay God. Kasi hindi naman kasi lahat ng bagay kaya mong gawin mag-isa. That is why, saan yung pagtabang sa awag ng tao? Paano ko raw paano daw ako makakatulong sa ibang tao? Eh, yun. Yun nga, continue lang sa pagbibigay ng inspiration sa kanila. So, yes. Next is, kasi yung first subscriber ni mo. Sino daw yung first subscriber ko? Actually, hindi ko kasi makita sa list. Wala kasing list sa YouTube kung sino yung first subscriber mo or sino yung mga nag-subscribe sa'yo. So, whoever man, ikaw, na first subscriber na ho, is, I don't know who you are, but all I want to say is, thank you. Thank you for subscribing me. So, next is, how do you see yourself 10 years from now? Okay, 10 years from now, so since I'm a 16-year-old, then 10 years from now, so I'm 26-year-old. So, I want to see myself 10 years from now is, yung nakapag-finish na ko sa pag-aaral ko, a teacher. I want to see myself 10 years from now as a teacher, a successful businesswoman, and of course, a happy family. Happy family. And most important of all is, yung nakatulong na ako sa maraming tao, then, continue, gusto ko makita yung buhay ko 10 years, sarili ko 10 years from now as a servant of God. So, yeah. Next is, what do you want to achieve in your life? Siguro ano lang, I want to achieve my life. Yun nga, my connection lang siya sa isang question. What do you want to achieve in your life? Of course, success. But before success, together with success, I want to achieve also a blessed life. Yung ano, yung gusto kong ma-achieve na marami akong natutulungan ng mga tao. Kasama ng success at magiging blessed ko isang tao, gusto ko rin makatulong. Gusto kong ma-achieve sa life ko yung maraming natulungan ng mga tao. Hindi lang tao, but as well as the environment and of course the animals. Since I'm an animal lover, so I want to achieve in my life na makatulong sa ibang tao and of course that's with together with success. Okay, so 10 years from now, mag-vlog paghihapon ka. Why? So, sabi ni Tordain is 10 years from now, mag-vlog pa ba daw ako? So, of course naman, yes. It's a yes. Since I want to continue what I'm doing right now and I want to share and help other people as well. Next question is, what's your favorite verse nimo that gives you motivation to strive and to gain more title? So, my favorite verse that gives me motivation to strive and to gain more title is, my very favorite verse is the Philippians chapter 4 verse 13. Why? Ano bang meron sa verse na yan? Bakit ko paborito? Since, I consider this verse as also my life verse. This verse, Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, says that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So, sinasabi lang dito na lahat ng ginagawa mo ay makakaya mo. Lahat. Walang imposible. Lalo na pagkasama mo si God. So that's my favorite verse. Next question ni Atrodain is, what's your characteristic and traits ni mo sa vlogger? So characteristic and traits na ko as a vlogger is maybe the characteristic of being. Yung mahilig sa mga tutorial. I don't know what's the term for that, pero gusto sa content ko kasi more on content na ko sa kong to my vlog is more on tutorials. So, characteristic and traits nimo. Siguro yung mahilig sa pag-spread ng knowledge and tutorials. Ganun. I don't know what's the term, but yeah, it's more on like that. Okay, so yes! Shout out dai! Okay, shout out to Ate Rodain who gave me a lot, the most questions na kung na-answer. It's more than No, it's 9 questions. Actually, siya lang yung nagbigay sa akin ng 9 questions. It's so many. Wow. So, shout out to Ate Dane. She is such a God-fearing girl. And so, butan niya siya. Mabait. So, I like how you dress, Ate Dane. So modest. So, shout out to you, Ate Dane. Ate Dane. Okay, so next question. A question from... Okay. A question from... Oh, no. From Miss Arabella Ido. Okay.
Hello.
Ideal man's personality. Okay, so yung gusto ko lang naman is a hardworking, masipag, mabait, and mapagmahal sa pamilya, sa kapwa as well, matulungin, marunong umintindi, and of course, most important of all is may takot sa Diyos and God-fearing. So yeah, next question to Miss Arabella Edo is, have you ever fall in love? Have I fall in love? So be in mundo. Come on to us teenagers naman, di ba? So, yeah. But, as sa mga ano lang, sa mga crush, ganon. Since my priority for now is to finish my studies rather than about love. So, saka muna yung mga ganyan pag tapos na sa pag-aaral, then fulfill ko na yung mga dreams ko sa buhay. So, have I ever fallen in love? Sa mga crush, yeah, ganon. Yeah. Okay, next question is... Ta-da! From Mr. Jesus San Dipusoy. Shout out to this man since marunong talaga siyang mag-drawing. So, it's a classmate of mine. So, shout out to you, Jesus San. Okay, his question is, unsa na subject ang pinakamahirap nimo? So, anong subject ang pinakamahirap sa akin? Actually, I can say na only one subject since it depends on the lesson. Depende sa lesson kung... Depende kung saan ang subject ko mahihirapan. Depende sa lesson. Kasi minsan, yung English mahirap. May lesson sa English na mahirap. Sa math rin, meron. Sa science, and to the other subject, the rest of the subject is may mga hirap, but may mga mahirap. But, kung saan sabi ka pinakamahirap ni mo, so, maybe sometimes, or yung mas nag, ano talaga na subject na pinakamahirap sa akin is English. But not, I can say na as in, hindi talaga ako marunong sa English, but it depends, it's like what I say before, it depends on the lesson that was the teacher was discussing. So, but sometimes English, and sometimes also, but much prefer, mas mahihirapan ako sa English talaga minsan. So, next question is, how to be you po such an intelligent person?
Such an intelligent person.
Ano naman to? Grabe. Such an intelligent person. Hindi, I can't consider myself as an intelligent person. Since marami rin akong mga hindi alam. Sa if about sa studies, marami rin akong hindi alam. But, so I can't consider myself as an intelligent person. Ano lang, tama lang. Tama lang naman yung alam ko. So, don't consider me as an intelligent person. Because I'm not a wizard. I'm not a math wizard, science wizard, English wizard, and subject wizard. That's... actually how to be me, such an intelligent person. Just like I said, I'm not an intelligent person, but I want to give you some tips lang naman kung paano maging mag-stand out sa class. Okay, you only need lang naman to believe in yourself, of course. Believe in yourself that you can do what you're doing. And then, listen to the teacher while discussing, and of course, taking down notes while the teacher was discussing. And then, habang nakikinig ka sa teacher mo, habang nag-discuss, is isipin mo at intindihin mo ng maigi kung ano nga bang dinidiscuss ng teacher. Then, ilagay mo yun sa isipan mo at saka huwag mong kalimutan. Tandaan mo. So, that's some tips lang naman to become an intelligent person. But, just like I've said, I'm not an intelligent person. Okay, so next question. Next question is, ta-da! From Miss Kayla Nicole Siscon. Okay, so shout out to this girl. Just ano siya, mabait talaga siyang kaibigan. So hindi pa kami masyadong close noon, but nung for the past months is medyo nagka-close kami. So shout out to you, Kayla. Thank you for everything. Okay, her question is, what is your biggest fear? So what's my biggest fear? Actually, my biggest fear is losing a family. Losing a loved ones. Mawala ng minamahal sa buhay. Mawala ng pamilya. So, yeah. Since hindi ako sanay na mag-isa. So, yeah. Next question, Bilay, is... Ta-da! A question from... Sensya nyo na to guys, sa tingnan nyo. Hindi ko siya na-roll ng tama. Okay, so... From a classmate, of course, from Mr. Nestor Virador. Okay, so what is your favorite color? What's my favorite color? I only have two favorite color, the pink and the light blue color. Since if you combine those two colors, is napakaganda nga naman ng combination nilang dalawa. So yes, that's my favorite colors. Next questions. A question from Ate Kristen Ayuban. Hi, Ate Kristen! Okay, so, if you are given a chance to be reborn, would it be in the past or in the future? And why? So, if I'm given a chance to be reborn, I would rather choose to be reborn in the past than the future. Why I choose to be reborn in the past? Since, hindi naman tayong lahat magaganda yung mga past natin, diba? So, mas pinili ko na ma-reborn sa past kasi gusto ko na balikan lahat ng mga past ko. But, hindi ko na siya sasayangin yung mga pagkakataon na nasayang ko noon. I want to make and turn my past into a better experience and a better life. That rather than the future na parang tinatakasan mo na yung kung anumang mga nangyayari. But if I want, that's why I want to be reborn in the past kasi gusto kong i-face lahat ng mga problems ng hindi na, gusto kong harapin, yes, harapin yung mga problems ko noon, mga challenges na mga past ko, together with God. Hindi na yung like noon na parang nasayang lang yung mga nangyari, then parang hindi ko kinaya. So I want to turn my past into a better experience and a better life. So, I want to reborn in the past. Okay, next question. A question. Wow. A question from a cute classmate. Okay, so Miss Eden Inghog. Hi Din! Shout out to this girl. She's so have a cute voice like this.
Hi Claire! Muhatag ko ni mo question!
Okay, that's a joke din, but it's true naman talaga na cute yung voice ni Din. Aside from her height, na cute rin yung voice niya. Shout out to you, Din. Okay, so her question is, sa math, ganong kinahanglan pa man pangitaon si X para makasolve? So, X, what kind of X are you asking? Then, so is it an X? A letter X? Or maybe X? X, alam niyo na yun. Alam niyo na yun kung ano yung X na yun. Si X. Ngunong kinahanglan pa man pangitaon si X para makasolve? Bakit pa daw kailangan pang hanapin si X para makasolve? Bakit? Sino ba yan si X? Bakit kailangan ko pang hanapin? Actually, si X kasi, siya lang naman yung kasi isang taong nagbigay sa'yo ng depression, nagbigay sa'yo ng kasakit. Si X lang naman kasi yung taong nagbigay sa'yo ng sakit na hanggang ngayon hindi mo pa makakalimutan at hanggang nandito pa talaga. No. That's a joke. Joke! Okay, so walang kinahanglan pa man si X para pangitaon si X para makasolve. Since, in the mathematics is si X yung kinukonsider na hinahanap. Si X yung X stands for the missing quantity, missing number, missing thing. So you need to solve for X. To find the right answer. Apparently, X stands for the missing. So you need to find X to solve the entire problem. So yes, X. X is a letter. Not X na naghatag kanimo. Kasakin. Okay, joke! Next question. From Kuya MK. So, hindi ko na lang sasabihin yung true identity niya since he requested me not to say his true identity. So, Kuya MK lang muna. From Kuya MK is, how you cope up with your biggest problems? Of course, how I cope up with my biggest problems? I only have one thing. So, that is prayer. Prayer and of course have faith and trust in God. So that's how I cope up with my biggest problems. Next is, for you, what is love and how do you define love? For me, love is a most powerful emotion against everything or anything and for anything. Against and for. So against is against any problems. So, what is love? It's a strong feeling or strong emotion. Kasi, sa pamagitan ng love, lahat nakakaya mo, di ba? Lahat nakakaya mo. Especially yung mga bagay na akala mo hindi mo kaya. Akala mo hindi mo malalabanan. Pero, by love, true love, is hindi mo in-expect na kaya mo pala yung mga bagay na yun. At, kakayanin mo pa para sa mga taong minamahal mo. And for anything or everything naman, love is a most powerful emotion or feeling for anything, for someone, di ba? For your family and your friends. Since, that's what I've said lately, lahat kakayanin mo by love. And especially, it's a very strong feeling or emotion because it turned such geniuses, mga matatalino, into fools. Mga matatalino nagiging tanga, 'di ba? Marami diyan sa inyo. Matatalino nagiging tanga, mga bulag nakakakita, mga mali tinatama or mga tama nagiging mali. At most important is by love, nagagawa ng isang tao na magbago and strive for the better. para sa taong mahal niya, para sa pamilya niya, at para sa mga kaibigan niya. Nagagawa ng isang tao na magsakripisyo dahil sa pagmamahal. So yes, that's it. What is love all about? Next question is, from Rick Suguran, what is the most challenging part to you as a student? Kato face-to-face pa. So the most challenging part to me as a student is when we are having a performance task. Not individual, but as a group. Since you really need to have a patience, pasensya, kailangan mo talaga ng pasensya, kailangan mo ng time management since it's a group performance task. Kailangan mong, hindi dapat na sarili mo yung iniisip mo, but yung kapakanan ng buong grupo. So that's the most challenging part to me as a student, since mostly if we're having a performance task as a group is ako talaga yung naging leader. So it's so challenging part to me. Yes. Ta-da! So next question will be from Miss Hannah Tadlas. So her question is hate subject. Actually, no, I don't have a hate subject. So no hate subject. I love all the subject and wala akong hate the subject. So yes, from Hannah Tadlas, hi. Next question is from Miss Mary Joy Bayukot. Yes? What characteristic do you possess that makes you unique and different? Well, I have this characteristic na parang nalalaman ko agad yung kung ano yung iniisip ng isang tao. Ano yung iniisip ng tao? Ano yung maaari niyang gawin? Ano yung nararamdaman niya? I don't know, pero example, yung isang tingin ko lang parang first impression ko sa isang tao is parang nagkakatotoo, yung mga ganun. Or anything na ma-feel ko sa isang tao is yun talaga yung mga nangyari. Parang I have the kind of characteristic na marunong mag-predict kung ano yung na-feel, marin gawin, or ano yung na-feel ng isang tao for someone. So, and of course, the characteristic of being friendly. Hi! If you want to be friend with mine, I'm so open for friendship. So yes, next question is goals in life. Yes, I already answered it. Goals in life is to become a successful businesswoman, teacher, and of course, finish my studies first. Okay, next is, why do men cheat? So, in this question, in my opinion, maybe hindi lang sila seryoso sa'yo, hindi sila seryoso, o hindi talaga nila kayang panindigan kung ano man yung mga pangako nila sa'yo. Next is, what's your story behind your vlogging? I mean, kinsa yung nag-udyok ni mo para mag-vlog? So, walang sino man yung nag-udyok sa akin para mag-vlog. I was just inspired by Miss Mimiu, a vlogger na yumaman na rin sa ngayon. So, she inspired me na na-inspired ako nakikita pala sa YouTube. So, gusto ko a sideline siguro, pero it's not as easy like that, like a one snap. Pero, kasi na-udyok, what's your story behind your vlogging? I was just inspired by Miss Mimiu na from a normal vlogger into such an sikat na siya na vlogger ngayon. And of course, success. Nakatulong lang siya hindi sa sarili niya, sa pamilya niya, and of course, sa ibang tao. So, yes. Next question is this from Ate Justin Cadenas. Hi, Ate Justin. Talagang medyo nakakatawa rin itong question mo. Okay. Actually, question kasi ni Ate Justin is, magsusuka ka ba pag sasakay ng bus? So, yeah. Oo. Nasusuka talaga ako. Actually, hindi lang bus, pati van. Ano lang kasi, dahil siguro sa amoy, parang nahihilo ako. So, parang I don't know, nakakahilo talaga. So, hindi ako sanay na bumiyahe palagi. Kasi, nanghihina talaga ako. Nagsusuka. Like, especially if pupunta kami ng Jollibee, doon kami kakain, hindi ko talaga ma-enjoy yung food. Since, alam po sa sarili ko na pag-uwi namin, isusuka ko rin naman lahat.
Okay, next question is, so, I only have 4 questions left. Next question is,
oh, from Miss Lisbeth Sugala. Hi, Lisbeth, my very best friend in MTAP from a contest in elementary in mathematics. So, dream job, yes, to become a teacher. In what? A bachelor in secondary education, major in mathematics. Secondary teacher in mathematics. Yeah, wow, that's my dream job. Next is, ta-da! From a classmate, from Charles Noronio. So his question is, unsaon di ay para mo taas ang grade? So ano lang gagawin para tumaas yung grade mo? Of course, mag-aral ka lang na mabuti. Yun lang naman yun. Maniwala ka sa sarili mo na kaya mo. Huwag kang mahiya na sumagot pag alam mo yung answer kapag nag-discuss yung teacher niyo or nagtatanong yung teacher niyo. And most important is taking down notes at saka yung tinitake down mo na notes while the teacher was discussing is yun yung pag-aaralan mo. Para naman may matutunan ka and during while the teacher was discussing, of course, makinig. Huwag kang gumawa ng mga kung ano-ano. Since yan lang naman yung mga tips na pwede mong gawin para tumaas yung grades mo. Okay, next question is, oh, it only have 2 questions left. Ta-da! Oh, from Kuya Daniel Hasok. His question is, is there a pressure in you nga na kag maestra? Like, what I mean, you should be achiever kay anak kag teacher. Oh, sa nga hindi pa nakakalam, yeah, I'm a daughter of a teacher. But, based on the question of Kuya Daniel, is there a pressure in you nga na kag maestra? Like, you should be achiever. So, is there a pressure in me? That's the question. So, my answer is no. Why? Since, what I'm just doing lang naman is kung ano yung makakaya ko. Ginagawa ko lang naman yung, sa tingin ko, kaya ko. Hindi ko yung pinipressure yung self ko na kailangan top 1, always top 1 in everything, sa contest, sa class, or sa anything na challenge. No. Because, what's more important lang kasi, especially sa studies mo, hindi naman kasi nakabase kung anak ka ng teacher or hindi. What really matters is may natutunan ka sa pag-aaral mo na maaari mo rin maitulong sa iba. Hindi nakabase na dapat anak, dahil anak ka ng teacher, yun yung dahilan. But for me, ginawa ko lang naman yung ano yung makakaya ko, nag-aral ako ng mabuti, but, of course, sa pag-aaral ko ng mabuti, sinasama ko si God. Humihingi ako ng tulong sa kanya. Yun lang naman yun eh. Hindi ko dapat pinipressure yung sarili ko na maging achiever. Ginagawa ko lang naman kung ano yung makakaya ko. Next is dream job and destination. So yeah, I already answered about the dream job is to become a teacher. And then dream destination is to be in Hong Kong Disneyland. Kasi, sa Hong Kong kasi, I don't know, pero yung pinakagusto ko lang talaga is Hong Kong because of the Disneyland. Kasi gusto ko makita doon ng mga Disney princesses. Since I'm a child, is gusto ko talaga makakita at makapunta sa Hong Kong Disneyland. Like, fireworks here, parade here, kung saan nandun sina Elsa, Anna, Belle, Cinderella, and Snow White. So, gusto kong ma-experience yung I want to fulfill my childhood dreams. Yun, na makapunta sa Hong Kong Disneyland. Okay, next question is the one and only last question. Yay! From Miss Jessame Salvacion. Hi, Jessame! She's my best friend during my junior high school. Then, ngayon kasi, pumunta na siya ng Maynila. So, but we're still friends. Best friends. So, her question is, okay, shout out to this girl. Hi, Jessa. Is, what is your favorite subject and why? So, my favorite subject, the subject that stands out than the other subject is mathematics. I could say that I'm like a math wizard, or I have a lot of knowledge about mathematics. That's why talagang favorite ko yung mathematics. But because favorite ko yung mathematics because meron siyang solution. Kasi if mag-solve ka, then alam mo yung solution. So, talaga makukuha mo yung, apparently, makukuha mo yung right answer. Directly to the right answer. Unlike the other subject na with explanation, or may kailangan ka pang gawin step by step. Yes, mathematics during solving is also step by step, but I want mathematics. My favorite is mathematics because masusure mo talaga yung right answer. But I can say na I have a lot of knowledge, but most favorite subject of mine is mathematics kasi sa mga solution which lead to the right answer. So that's my favorite subject, mathematics. Yeah! And now we're finished answering all the questions here.
Oh no!
Okay guys, so thank you very much for watching my vlog, and hopefully is you learned something about myself, about anything, and of course I give you a lessons in your life that you can really include in achieving your dreams, fulfilling your dreams. So hopefully nag-enjoy kayo sa pagtingin ng vlog ko, and of course hindi kayo masyadong na boring. Okay, so again, thank you for watching my vlog, and please don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and like and share. So thank you so much for watching my vlog, and see ya! Thank you very much! See ya!